Jaya Radha Madhava Punya Vihari
भगवते वासुदेवाय
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकय चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपकदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकम् जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण सो थैंक यू ऑल फॉर काइंडली असेंबलिंग दिस मॉर्निंग माय सिंसियर ग्रेटिट्यूड टू हिज ग्रेस हरिक्षेत्र प्रभु हिज ग्रेस कार्तिकेय प्रभु एंड ऑल द वंडरफुल सीनियर वैष्णवस हियर फॉर काइंडली एंगेजिंग मी इन द सर्विस संडे मॉर्निंग It's very wonderful to hear and speak and remember Sri Hari. Because in the material realm, they use Monday to Friday for hard work and Saturday, Sunday for relaxing. But in the life of a devotee, every day is hard work. Every single day. Because we never know when we will breathe our last. If we are going to die this evening, it should be in such a way that we are satisfied that at least even this morning, this afternoon, and this evening, we could try our best to engage in Krishna Seva. So thank you that we're all starting this morning in the service of Sri Hari. So as we know, day before yesterday, we celebrated Sri Radhashtami. This tithi of Radhashtami is the most auspicious tithi on the calendar. Janmashtami is certainly very glorious because it marks the appearance of Bhagavan Sri Krishna. But the Shastras describe
Natasya karyam karanam cha vidyate na tat samah cha adhikash cha drishyate Parasya Shaktir Vividhaiva Shruyate Swabhaviki Jnana Balakriyacha Upanishad describes that Bhagavan is Bhagavan and therefore Na Tasya Karyam Karanam Cha Vidhyate. There is no activity that he has to perform in this world. Every activity that we perform, there is a hetu, there is a purpose, right? We want Ananda Prapti. We want happiness. So every second we are thinking, what should I see so that I can become happy? What should I taste so that I can become happy? What should I hear so that I can become happy? What should I smell so that I can become happy? Huh? What should the sense of touch do so that I can become happy? What should I think so that I can become happy? What decision should I make so that I can become happy? In this theme, we have spent millions and billions of births. Same theme. Ananda Prapti. We want to become happy. So we know my mind, my body, my finger, my intelligence, but who that I is still a million-dollar question. And then comes the question, how to keep that I happy? First, we have to know who that I is. Then we have to know how to keep that I happy. But when we don't know who that I is, and we think, yes, I am male, I am female, and then because I am male and female, I am somebody's daughter or somebody's son, somebody's father or somebody's mother, somebody's brother or somebody's sister, and naturally I am Indian, I am American, I am Australian, I am Britisher. And then once you settle that you're Indian, I'm South Indian, I'm North Indian. Then once you settle, I'm South Indian. Then I am from Andhra Pradesh, I'm from Telangana. And then which village? Arre, we have gone up to where? No limit. How many fake titles have we put on our identity? And because we are confused who that I is, we are definitely confused how to keep that I happy. And because of this, innumerable births have gone wasted. So every activity that we perform is only with this thought process, how to become happy. Kya dekhun taki main prasanna ho jaun, anand ho jaun, anandit rahun. Kya sunun, kya chakhun, kya karun, kya sochun. This is the thought process. So therefore, every activity that we perform has this purpose behind it. Hence, it is very difficult for us to be selfless. But Krishna, na tasya karyam karanam cha vidyate. He is Ananda Swarup. He doesn't have to do any endeavor to get anything. He has everything. So there is no need for him to come in this world. But why does he come? Paritranaya sadhunam vinashaya cha duskritam dharma samsthapanarthaya sambhavami yuge yuge. Yes, he comes to protect the devotees, to destroy the demons and to re-establish dharma. But the interesting thing is protecting of the devotees Krishna nam does. So Krishna does not have to come. How many times did Narasimha come for Prahlad? Once. But how many times was the name protecting Prahlad? Many times. So the Lord doesn't have to come to protect the devotees. The name protects. Vinashaya cha duskritam. Well, the Lord doesn't have to come to destroy the demons. Earthquakes are enough. Tsunami. Hurricane. It's very easy for Hari to use his cane. He doesn't have to come. Material nature. Prakriti. Gunai karmani sarvashaha. Prakriti kriyamanani. 327 Gita. So Prakriti does everything to destroy the demons also. Supreme Lord doesn't have to come. Then why is he coming? Dharma samsthapanarthaya. Well, that also he doesn't have to do. Just send one Prabhupada, enough. Dharma is taken care. Not just taken care, nourished. Kali Yuga is now scared. Hare Krishna bhaktayo. If I go to give him my association, kotha nidra jaye maye pisha chira kole. Jeeva jago gaura chandra bole. So, protecting is done by the holy name, destruction is done by material nature, re-establishment of dharma is done by pure devotees. So, why he comes? Prapanche nishprapanchopi vidhambhayasi bhutale prapanna janatanando sandoham pratitum prabho. Brahma stuti, Bhagavat. Brahma is saying, why the Lord comes? Oh, very simple. Prapanna janata ananda sandoham. He comes only to give happiness to those who are surrendered devotees. Oh, you're performing bhajan for me. To keep you happy, I'm coming. Na tasya karyam karanam cha vidyate. He has nothing to achieve in this world. Why? Na tat sama cha adhikas cha drishyate. There is no one equal or greater to him. He is the supreme. He comes in this world and interacts with his pure devotees. This is why he comes. Prapanche nishprapanchopi. Although he is outside the prapancha, nishprapancha, still prapancha, he enters this prapancha only to have adan pradan, reciprocation with his devotees. Now when he reciprocates, what does he do? Please repeat. Anugrahaya bhaktanam,
anugrahaya bhaktanam,
manusham dehamasthitah,
manusham dehamasthitah,
bhajate tadrishi krida,
ya
shrutva tat paro bhavet. Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 10, Chapter 33, Text 36. Anugrahaya bhaktanam. Oh, he comes only to shower mercy on his devotees. Anugraha bhaktanam. And manusham deham astitaha. He appears human-like. Not human. Avajananti mamudha manushim tanumashritam. Not human, human-like. Anugrahaya bhaktanam manusham deham astitaha. He appears with two hands, two legs. What is the mercy factor of Krishna here? Well, the mercy factor is angani yasya sakalendriya vrittimanti pashyanti panti kalayanti chiram jaganti. Oh, he can hear through his eyes. He can taste through his nose. He can walk through his ears. But the mercy is to relate to us. He agrees to hear only through his ear. He agrees to taste only through his mouth. He agrees to see only through his eyes. This is the mercy for relatability. And bhajate tadrashi krida. He performs such pastimes. Ya shrutva, hearing which tat paro bhavet, the living being can get delivered. This is why he comes in this world. He comes only to help us. Perform pastimes, attract our mind so that we remember him and finished. This is why he comes. But the interesting thing is, the energetic cannot perform anything without the energy. To perform any activity, parasya shakti vividhaiva shruyate. He comes in this world, but he performs activities through his shakti. You see, when someone is very tired, he said, don't talk to me, I'm very tired now. So he's alive, but no use because he has no energy. But the same thing, if he has energy, you can dance in kirtan with him. So what brings in life is energy. Pran ache jar, tar hetu prachar. Saraswati Thakur said, wherever there is pran, there must be preaching. Pran, life. So Janmashtami mentions the occasion of Krishna out of mercy coming in our domain, our purview. But Radhashtami marks the energy of the Lord to be able to do what he's doing on Janmashtami. So therefore, the most auspicious tithi on the calendar is Sri Radhashtami. Between Radharani and Sri Krishna, Srimati Radharani is more glorious. As we know the famous story, when Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada was with his dear disciples on the banks of Radhakund, the king of Jaipur was performing Dandavat Parikrama. So when you perform Parikrama with your foot, it's Parikrama. But when you offer obeisances and complete a Parikrama, it's called Dandavati Parikrama. You offer obeisances and you complete. So the disciples told Prabhupada Saraswati Thakur, oh, look at the king of Jaipur. He has so much love for Krishna. Saraswati Thakur said, yes. But there's a difference between their mood and our mood. What is the difference? He said, their main focus, their main sadhya, their main goal is to please Krishna. And because Krishna is pleased by serving Srimati Radharani, they serve Srimati Radharani. But he said, for the Gaudiyas, it is the exact opposite. Our main sadhya, our main goal is the lotus feet of Srimati Radharani. And because she is pleased by we giving one flower to Krishna, we give him one flower. Saraswati Thakur said this. So those who worship Vishnu are called Vaishnavas. Those who worship only Krishna are called Karshnavas. Ashnayas. But those who worship Param Gauri, Srimati Radharani, are called Gaudiyas. So to be a Gaudiya means to be completely surrendered and fanatically devoted to the lotus feet and the service of Srimati Radharani. This is the Gaudiya Parampara. If this is not our mood, then we are in the wrong parampara. This line that we have, this wonderful Gaudiya Sampradaya that we have, they're all surrendered to Srimati Radharani. Gaur Kishor Das Babaji Maharaj had nothing in this world. He just had a kopin, and he didn't even have neck beads sometimes. He would just take a cloth and wrap it into 108 knots, and he would chant, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram. But that Gaur Kishor Das Babaji Maharaj, who didn't possess anything in the world, he would chant the names of Srimati Radharani. He would say, Kothai go prema mai radhe radhe, Ashtasaki shiromani radhe radhe, Krishna prema pradayini radhe radhe, Govinda vimohini radhe radhe, Krishna manamohini radhe radhe, Kannu manamohini radhe radhe, Vrindavaneshwari radhe radhe. Like that, Gaur Kishor Das Babaji Maharaj would sing. Oh, where is Srimati Radharani? Devotees, if you can come little ahead, because I think devotees are coming from behind, so they'll have some spot. We have so much space here. So first layer, maybe Prabhuji's can sit and then Mataji's can sit. You can come ahead. Kids can sit around and then Mataji's can sit later. Yeah, but the condition is no talking and no giving commentaries, okay? Yeah, good. Now the place is occupied. Very nice. Lot of devotees coming, so please come ahead. So the point is, our whole sampradaya is sold out at the lotus feet of Srimati Radharani. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur was in this mood. Srila Gaur Kishor Das Babaji Maharaj was in this mood. On the banks of Radhakund, he would just go on crying the names of Radharani. His Gurudev, Sachitananda Bhakti Vinod Thakur Mahashay, he so surrendered to Srimati Radharani that in this world, we are all afraid of death. But Thakur Bhakti Vinod is not afraid of death. He is making post-death plans. We are thinking, oh, very soon I will die. Everything will be taken away from me. Prana prayana samaye kapa vata pittaihi kanthava rodhana vidam. Everything will be gone. Mrityuhu sarva harashchaham. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur is singing. Vrishabhanu pure janamalaiva yavata vivaha have. He is not just planning what is going to happen at death. Post-death, he is making plans where I am going to appear. Vrishabhanu pure janamalaiva. Ah, when will death come? Because as soon as I give up this old body, Vrishabhanupure janamaloibo. Oh, I will take birth in Vrishabhanupur or Barsana Dham. And in a Kishori form, in a young girl, in the form of a young girl, Yavata Vivaha Hobe. I will get married to Yavat. So he'll get married to some Gopa in Yavat. So he's not afraid of death. He's planned even up to his marriage in his next birth. There's no one in this whole creation who does this except Thakur Mahashay. Vrishabhanu pure janamalaiva yavata vivaha have. Why? He's so surrendered to the lotus feet of Srimati Radhika, Srimati Radharani, that he knows Srimati Radharani is from Barsana Dham, but she is very mysteriously married to Abhimanyu in Yavat. So as a result of which, what happens? Her heart is in Barsana, at the lotus feet of Sri Krishna Chandra, in the house of Vrishabhanu Maharaj. But her body has to go to Yavat. For Radharani, it's a little difficult because the forest of Vrindavan, the forest is her home, and her home is a forest. Because who's there in a forest? Wild animals. Jatila, Kutila, Abhimanyu. They're all like wild animals. So the home of Radharani is a forest, but the forest is actually her home. So Radharani, she's from Barsana, but she has to go to Yavat, to her father-in-law's place and mother-in-law, Jatila's place. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur is making plan. Next life, if I become a Brajasakhi, a Palyadasi, a Kishori, then I can be born in Barsana like Srimati Radharani, and then I can get married to someone in Yavat, so that when Radharani is crying in Yavat, she will have some solace, some maid servant who can fan her and pacify her. And at the same time, when she's going from Barsana to Yavat and she gets a break and comes back to Barsana, she would need someone in her palanquin to serve her. I can do that service. This is Bhaktivinoda Thakur's meditation. Where is the fear of death? You see, death is like a snake. When we are 25 years old, that snake has eaten us up to the knee. When we are 50 years old, that snake of death has eaten us up to the waist. Then when we are 75 years old, that snake has eaten us up to the chest. And then when anything after that is grace. So we are all in the mouth of that snake. And we are trying to think of mera kya hoga. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur is making so many plans, and all of them are driven towards the service of Radharani. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is singing, Ramani Shiromani Vrishabhanu Nandini. Oh, Ramani Shiromani, the crown on top of all the Brajbasis is Vrishabhanu Nandini, Radharani. So this is our parampara. They're all sold out at the feet of Srimati Radharani. Six Goswami is also like this. Please come to the texts of Sripad Sanatan Goswami. We will go one by one. Sripad Sanatan Goswami. Sripad Sanatan Goswami, in his Krishna Lila Stava, he is chanting prayer for Krishna. But he's so surrendered to Radharani, he's only chanting the names of Radharani to offer pranam to Krishna. Please chant Krishna's pranam. Radha Radhita Radhesha.
Radha Radhita Radhesha.
Radhika Prana Vallabha.
Radhika Prana Vallabha.
Radha Ramana Vandetvam.
Radha Ramana Vandetvam.
Radhika Prema Nirjita.
Radhika Prema Nirjita.
So whom is he offering obeisances to? Externally to Krishna, internally to Radharani. Radha Aradhita. So beautiful. He's calling Krishna as Radha Aradhita. Oh, he who is worshipped by Radharani. Radha Aradhita Radhesha. Oh, that Krishna who is the Lord of Radharani. Radhika Prana Vallabha. Oh, he who is very dear to the life air of Radharani. Radha Ramana. Oh, he who gives pleasure to Srimati Radharani. Vandetvam, I bow down to you. Why? Radhika Prema Nirjita. Because you are completely conquered by the loving service of Srimati Radharani. So, kin ke liye pranam hai? Krishna ke liye ki Radharani ke liye? This is Sripad Sanatan Goswami. Sripad Sanatan Goswami. Any announcements to be made? Idamasanam swagatam swagatam su swagatam. Just like you see when you invite a deity early in the morning, you say, Suswagatam, Idam Asanam Klim Krishna Ayanama. Padharosa. So our Sripad Sanatan Goswami, Sambandha Acharya, so surrendered to Radharani, that even in the Brihad Bhagavatamrita, when he mentions the search of Narada Muni for the greatest devotee, he says Narada Muni went around searching for the greatest devotee. And finally, moving around, he came to Indra. He said, Indra, you're the best devotee. Indra said, no, haven't you read Govardhan Leela? How am I the best devotee? I made Krishna do all the vyayam because of me. So I'm not the best devotee. Then Narad Muni said, then please tell me who's the best devotee. He said, according to me, Brahma is the best devotee. So Narad Muni went to Brahmaji. Brahma said, no, actually, I'm not the best devotee. Better than me is Indra. Why? Because Indra, he actually got the Brijbasis together under Govardhan. Although his mood was to destroy, inconceivable mercy, he got the Brajbasis under Krishna's shelter. They all wanted night out with Krishna. Because during daytime, Krishna's with the gopas. Nighttime, he's with the gopis. But the gopas want nighttime also, the gopis want daytime also. Greed. Krishna bhakti rasa bhavita mati kiyatam yadi kutopi labhyate tatra laulyam api mulyam ekalam koti janma sukritirna labhyate. Ramananda Rai. That the price to get Krishna is laulya, greed, laulyam. Lalasa, utkantha, ashabandha, samutkantha, namagane sadaruchi. So their desires were fulfilled by Indra. During the daytime, gopas and gopis. During nighttime, gopas and gopis. Because they have no other shelter except Giriraj. So Brahma is saying, actually Indra is better than me. What I did? I separated the cows from Krishna. The calves from Krishna. So he's better than me. Indra said, Narada Muni said, I cannot go back to Indra. He will send me back to you. Give me some other destination. Konsa address dalo GPS mein? Brahma said, oh, then better than me is Lord Shiva. And when Narada Muni went to Lord Shiva said, oh, actually I am the most abominable person. I am Muktinath. Devotees don't want mukti and I am going around giving what the devotees don't want. I am not doing Vaishnav Seva. Devotees are saying, Mama Janmani, Janmani Ishware, which means lifetime after lifetime, which means no mukti, and I am Muktinath. I am giving them mukti. Also, I come down as Adi Shankaracharya and I bring in twists to the whole story with Mayavad. So I am not the best devotee. Then Narada said, Acha, now please tell me my next destination. He said, oh, actually better than me is a personality called Prahlad. Because Prahlad served the Lord with so much love. Narada Muni went to his own disciple, Prahlad Maharaj. And he said, hey, I went around the whole world seeing who the best devotee is. Seems like it is my own disciple. Prahlad Maharaj said, oh Gurudev, I am the most abominable. I am good for nothing. When Narasingadev came, I didn't even offer him a seat. He sat on my father's throne. I didn't give him any mala, so he removed the intestines and he put a mala. And I didn't give him water to drink, so he drank the blood of my father. What kind of servant am I? Better than me is Hanumanji. Even when the tail was on fire, he served Sri Ram. Aha. So he went to Hanumanji now. Narada Muni is going to Hanumanji. Hanumanji, you are the best devotee. Hanumanji said, if that was true, why did the Lord make me a Chiranjeevi and leave me here while everyone is in Ayodhya? He said, Ramachandra told me, you're serving very nicely. Engage in service here. And he went there. So the Lord made me bereft of his association. So I'm not the best devotee. Better than me are the Pandavas, for whom Krishna gave personal association. Then Narada Muni went to the Pandavas. The Pandavas said, oh, actually, if somebody reads our story, they will give up devotion. What kind of devotees are we? We have done negative preaching. Hamare jaise mat bano. Krishna bhakti karoge to sab khona padega. Dhanam cha manam cha yathendriyani pranam charitva mama sarvameva kenapyaho bhishana chaura idrik drishta shrutova namaya kadapi. Vraje prasedham navanita choram gopanganam chadukula choram aneka janmarjita papa choram choragraganyam purusham namami choragraganyam purusham namami. Dhanam cha manam cha yathendra yatha indriyani pranam charitva mama sarvameva. Bilva Mangala Thakur is saying, Krishna is such an excellent thief. The more you give him, ye dil mange more. He wants more. Dhanam, he wants our wealth. Manam, our attention. Yatha indriyani, senses. Finally, prana. Life air. You see, you start chanting Hare Krishna initially 2 rounds, 4 rounds, 6 rounds. We start with giving 30 minutes of our time. Then how to convert that 30 into 1 hour, 1 hour into 2 hours, 2 hours into 3 hours is his headache. And he does it successfully. Ask our Kartikeya Prabhu. He started off chanting one round. Now Krishna has stolen his heart. All day and night he's only at the service of Sri Hari. Who stole? Krishna. So he's a very, very calculated thief. Kena pyoho bhishana chaura. Aisa adbhut chaur. Drishta shrutova na maya kadapi. Mere dwara aisa chaur na kabhi dekha hu na suna hu. So, sarcastic praise is offered. So Pandavas are telling Narada Muni, this is our story. Dhanam cha manam cha yathendriyani. Everything was stolen. Better than us as a devotee is Ugrasen Maharaj. Krishna left everything for him. But when Narada Muni went to Ugrasen Maharaj said, better than me is Uddhava. Uddhava is the dear friend of Krishna. When Narada Muni went to Uddhava, Uddhava said, Brajvasi is our dear to Krishna. Because I got training in Vrindavan. As I was saying last night, Uddhava got trained in VIHE. Vrindavan Institute of Higher Education. Because Uddhava didn't know what Braja Prema is, that higher education was given in Vrindavan. So therefore we have VIHE, following the footsteps of Uddhavji. Then among the Brajbasis, who are very dear, Ramya Kajid Upasana Braja Vadhum Barkhena Ya Kalpita Chaitanya Matta Manjusha Srinath Chakravarti. That among all the Brajbasis, the gopis are Shiromani. Among the gopis, the Ashtasakhi are Shiromani. But among the Ashtasakhi, it is Srimati Radharani. Greater than Srimati Radharani is no one. So Sanatan Goswami gives that whole story. Why? Only to sing the glories of Srimati Radharani. That's why he built up the whole story. Because those who are devotees of Brahmaji, Shivji, Prahlad Maharaj, Narsingadev, Hanuman, Pandavas, Mahabharat, sab attract karke unko story mein laya Sanatan Goswami ne. Aapko Hanuman ji ki story pasand hai? Are wah, aja aja, bahut achhi kahani hai. Acha, aapko Mahabharat pasand hai? Pandav ji bhi hai, aiye aiye. Then when they come, he steers them to Vraja, then Gopis, then Srimati Radharani, and then Srimati Radharani ki. Yeah. This is Sripad Sanatan Goswami. Now please come to the pages of Sripad Rupa Goswami. Rupa Goswami explains the whole of Govardhan Leela in one verse. And that too, using only two syllables, Ra and Dha. So intoxicated by Radhanam, that he wants to explain Govardhan Leela also using Radhanam. He says, Dhare dhara dhara dharam, dhara dhara dhurarudhi, dhira dhi ara radhadhi, rodham radha dhurandharam. So I will not go to explain this because it will take about 2 hours, every word. But however, Rupa Goswami is explaining, Dhare dhara dhara dharam, when Krishna held the Govardhan, why he held? Dhara dhara dhurarudhi. To obstruct the dhara which was coming from the top. At that time, dhira dhi ara radha, someone with a stable mind was worshipping him. Dhira dhi ara radha, adhirodham radha dhurandharam. That Radharani who was worshipping Dhurandhar, the hero of Vrindavan Krishna, while he was obstructing, I bow down to that Srimati Radharani. This is Rupa Goswami. Rupa Goswami says, please repeat. Radha Damodara Preshtha.
Radha Damodara
Preshtha. Gandharva Lalita Sakhi.
Gandharva Lalita Sakhi.
Vishakha Sakhya Sukhini.
Vishakha Sakhya Sukhini.
Hari Ridbringha Manjari.
Hari Ridbringha
Manjari. All names of Radharani. Radha is Radharani. Damodara Preshtha. Dear to Damodar, Radharani. Gandharvika, Radharani. Lalita Sakhi. Huh? How is this Radharani? This is Lalita Sakhi? No, 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 no. Lalita's Sakhi. She who is the Sakhi of Lalita. Like we sing in the song also. Rupa Goswami there also writes. Lalita Sakhi Guna Ramita Vishakhe. Ramita Vishakhe. Vishakha Sakhi is enchanted, Ramita, by the guna of who? Lalita Sakhi? No. Lalita's Sakhi, that is Radharani's gun, attracts Vishakha. Lalita Sakhi. Lalitayaha Sakhi. Guna. Ramita Vishakhe. Vishakha is enchanted by the qualities of the Sakhi of Lalita. Who is that Sakhi of Lalita? Radharani. So Lalita Sakhi is also the name of Radharani. Gandharva Lalita Sakhi. Next line. Vishakha Sakhya Sukhini. She who has Sukha by the Sakhya of Vishakha. That is Radharani again. And Hari Rid Bringa Manjari. She who is like a honeybee, tasting the honey of devotion service to the lotus of Krishna's heart. Hari Rit. Rit means heart. Bringa Manjari. She who is the honeybee tasting the honey of devotional service to the lotus of Krishna's heart. So all names of Radharani, Rupa Goswami is writing. Ha Devi Kakubara Gadgada Yadya Vacha Yache Nipatya Bhuvidanda Vadudbatarthi Asya Prasadam Abudasya Janasya Kritva Gandharvike Nijagane Gananam Videhi. This verse everyone in this community should know. Because this is a verse to Gandharvika. Rupa Goswami has composed. What does he say? Ha Devi. Please repeat.
Ha Devi.
Which means, O Srimati Radharani. Ha Devi. Kakubhara.
Kakubhara.
Gadgadayadhyavacha.
Gadgadayadhyavacha.
Oh, which means with words choking and kakubhara, begging with emotions. Ha Devi. Kakubhara. Gadgadayadhyavacha. With words choked. With emotions choking my throat, with tears, I am crying. Yache. I am begging. Nipatya. Falling at your lotus feet. Nipatya bhuvi, on Mother Earth. Yache nipatya bhuvi dandavad udbatarthi. Falling on the floor, I am rolling and giving obeisances, Radharani, with only one desire. What desire? Asya prasadam abhudasya janasya kritva. Give this one prasad to this abhudha. This fool. What prasad? Gandharvike nija gane gananam videhi. Oh Radharani, when you count the members in your team, please kindly count me. This is what we want. We all want to be under the shade and shelter of Srimati Radharani. So if Radharani is saying, so mere team mein kaun kaun hai? You know, sometimes cricket khelte time bacche count, do captains ho jate hain. अच्छा तुम किनको लोगे? मैं वो प्रभु जी को लेता हूँ. हाँ मैं इनको लूंगा, मैं उनको लूंगा. ऐसे करते करते दो टीम बट जाते हैं. एंड देन फाइनली एट द एंड द कैप्टन सेज, कौन कौन? 1 2 3. सो ही इज काउंटिंग हिज टीम. इमेजिन राधारानी काउंटिंग हर टीम. 1 2 ललिता विशाखा. देन वी आर ऑल्सो स्टैंडिंग. 1 2. रूप गोस्वामी सेज, गांधर्वी के निज गणे गणनाम विदेही. वेन यू काउंट योर टीम, जस्ट काउंट मी. बस कीप मी एट योर फीट. गिव मी सम सेवा फॉर कृष्ण. Because who gives service to Krishna? Only Radharani gives service. So if we want to serve Krishna, we must ask Radharani for blessings. Please repeat. Satyam satyam puna satyam.
Satyam satyam puna satyam.
Satyam eva puna punaha.
Satyam eva puna punaha.
Vinaradha prasadena.
Mat
prasado na labhyate. Krishna
is
saying, yeah, this is true, this is true, this is true. Satyam, satyam, punaha, satyam, satyam eva punaha, punaha. This is indeed true. Yeah, yeah, again I'm saying this is true. Yes, this definitely is true. What is true, Krishna? Vina radha prasadena. Without the mercy of Srimati Radharani, mat prasado na labhyate. No one can get me. So Rupa Goswami is praying like this. Acha. This is Rupa Goswami, Sanatan Goswami done. How about Jiva Goswami? Please come to the works of Jiva Goswami. Please repeat. Krishna prema mai radha.
Krishna prema mai
radha.
Radha prema mayo hari.
Jivane nidhane nityam.
Radha Krishna ugatir mama.
Jiva Goswami is saying Krishna prema mai radha. Who is Radharani? She is filled with Krishna prema. And Radha Prema Mayo Hari. Who is Hari? Filled with Radha Prema. Jivane, at life. Nidhane, at death. Nityam, eternally. Radha Krishna, Gatir Mama.
this Radharani and this Krishna are my life and soul, says Jiva Goswami. After composing 550,000 Sanskrit verses, this is the conclusion of Jiva Goswami. That Radha Krishna Pranamor Jugala Kishora Jivane Marane Gati Aranahi Mor. Whether at life or at death, I don't want anything except Radha Krishna. Jiva Goswami doesn't stop there. Krishna Dehe Stita Radha, Radha Dehe Stito Hari. Oh, that Radharani who's in the body of Krishna, that Krishna who's in the body of Radharani. Krishna Gehe Stita Radha, Radha Gehe Stito Hari. That Radharani who's in the house of Krishna, that Krishna who's in the house of Radharani. Krishnasya Dravinam Radha, Radhaya Dravino Hari. That Radharani who's the wealth of Krishna, that Krishna who's the wealth of Radharani. Neelam Bharadharo Radha, Peetam Bharadharo Hari. Oh, that Radharani who has a blue sari, that Krishna who has a yellow dhoti. Vrindavaneshwari Radha, Krishna Vrindavaneshwara. That Radharani who is Vrindavaneshwari, that Krishna who is Vrindavaneshwara, Jeevane Nidhane Nityam Radha Krishna Gatir Mama. So he is completely God intoxicated at the feet of Radha and Shyam. Radha and Shyam Sundar. So in this way, Radharani has been glorified profusely in the works of Jiva Goswami also. Now please come to the works of Gopal Bhatta Goswami's Guru Dev Prabodhananda Saraswati. Shripad Prabodhananda Saraswati has written a book called Radha Rasa Sudhanidhi, filled with Srimati Radharani's glories. And Prabodhananda Saraswati, being completely intoxicated, every verse of that book is in a different direction. You see, generally, an author, when he writes a book, chapter by chapter, there is proper flow. No work of Prabodhananda Saraswati has any flow. Because he's so intoxicated in divine ecstatic love, every verse is erupting in a different direction. One verse on Radha Nam Mahima, one verse on Vrindavan Dham, next verse. Next verse will be on the glories of the service of Radharani. Next verse will be on Radharani's lotus feet. Next verse will be on something else. So next verse will be on the leaves of Vrindavan. But it's kuch connection hi nahi. This person is so intoxicated that it is just filling his heart and it is erupting in ecstasy. So please come to the pages of Prabodhananda Saraswati. Everyone there in the class? Yes. Please repeat. Radha Karavachita Pallava Vallarike Radha Padanka Vilasan Madhurasthalike Radha Yasho Mukhara Matta Khagavalike Radha Vihara Vipine Ramatam Manome. So he is glorifying Vrindavan. But every word, every line is starting with Radha, 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 Radha. Radha Karavachita Pallava Vallarike. I bow down to those trees whose flowers have been personally plucked by the very soft bud-like fingers of Srimati Radharani. Radha Padanka Vilasan Madhurasthalike. Oh, I bow down to the pastime places which are all smeared with the signs and symbols imprinted from the lotus feet of Srimati Radharani. Radha Yasho Mukhara Matta Khagavalike. I bow down to the trees and the animals of Vrindavan who are constantly intoxicated singing the names of Radharani. Radha Vihara Vipine Ramatam Manome. May my heart get attached to that Vrindavan which is the home of Srimati Radharani. So the focus is somewhere else, the glorification goes somewhere else. He doesn't stop there. Listen to this. Radha sadhyam sadhanam yasya radha mantro radha mantra dhatri cha radha sarvam radha jivanam yasya radha 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 vachi kim tasya shesham. He is describing why he's alive. Radha sadhyam. Oh, the goal is the service of Radharani. And sadhanam yasya radha. And to get to that goal, the sadhana is serving Radharani in this world. Mantro radha.
the mantra to be chanted is Harinam, but Hare also means Radha. So mantra is also Radha. And mantra dhatri cha Radha. Guru who's giving that mantra is also representative of Radha. Prabodhanand Saraswati says, Sarvam Radha, Jivanam yasya Radha. Oh, everything around is only Radharani's mercy. And Jivanam, life, air is there to serve her. And on the tongue, Radha Radha Vachi. On the tongue, there is Radha Radha. Kim tasya shesham. What more desires are left unfulfilled? He's asking, ab puchne ke liye bacha kya hai? Sab kuch to Radha mai hai. So for Gaudiya Vaishnavas, this is the reality. Others may say, Sarvam khalu idam Brahma. But for the Gaudiyas, it is Sarvam khalu idam Radha. Everything is Radharani's mercy. Prabodhananda Saraswati doesn't stop there. Now look at him. Vaidagya sindhu anuraga rasaika sindhu. Vatsalya sindhu atisandra krupaika sindhu. Lavanya sindhu amrita chavirupa sindhu. Shri Radhika spuratume ridikeli sindhu. Sindhu means?
Ocean.
He's saying, Vaidagya sindhu. Oh, Radharani is an ocean of skills. Anuraga rasaika sindhu. At the same time, she's the only ocean of Krishna Prem. Everyone else who has Krishna Prem gets it from her. Vatsalya sindhu. At the same time, she's the ocean of affection for all the jivas. Vatsalya sindhu atisandra kripaika sindhu. She's the ocean of kripa for all the Kali jivas. Lavanya sindhu. Oh, she's also the ocean of spiritual beauty. Lavanya sindhu amrita chavi rupa sindhu. Oh, she's also an ocean of spotless beauty. Shri Radhika spuratume ridhi keli sindhu. May that Radharani appear in the ocean of my heart. Why ocean inside? Because Prabodhananda Saraswati is saying, like the ocean, my heart is salty with material desires. May that Radharani's mercy enter my heart. So in this way, he has composed so much. Tasya apara rasa sara vilasa murte ananda kanda paramadbhuta saukhya lakshmya brahmadi durlabhagate vrishabhanujaya kainkharyameva mama janmani janmani syat. Hey Prabodhananda Saraswati, what do you want? What is your ekameva icha? Prabodhananda Saraswati says, I have only one icha. What icha? Kainkaryam eva mama janmani janmani syat. Kainkaryam means service. May I have kainkaryam eva mama janmani janmani syat. Lifetime after lifetime, may I be connected to the service of Srimati Radharani. Bas mujhe aur kuch bhi nahi chahiye. Which Radharani? Yo brahma rudra shukha narada bhishma mukhyai. Alakshito nasahasa purushasya tasya sadhyo vashi karana churnam ananta shaktim tam radhika charana renum anusmarami. That Radharani, whose lotus feet has a very powerful quality. What quality? That Krishna who cannot be caught by 330 million demigods. Oh, he becomes a puppy dog. He becomes a stuffed toy, a pet doll. He becomes like a doll when a powder is smeared on him. Churanam. Ananta Shaktim. Tam Radhika Charana Renu Manuswarami. Prabodhananda Saraswati says, oh, the Supreme Lord of all creation. He becomes completely controlled. Mayam Rigam Dayita Yepsita Manvadhavat. Bhagavat. He becomes a very nice, cute little stuffed toy. Very obedient. When you Vashibhut. Sadhyo Vashikarana Churnam Ananta Shaktim. To bring him under control, one powder has to be put. Ananta Shaktim, very powerful dose. Hai. What is that? The dust from the lotus feet of Srimati Radharani. Now please tell me where you get that. You get that in the land of Braj. So the dust of Vrindavan is none different from the lotus foot dust of Srimati Radharani's lotus feet. So therefore you see devotees rolling in the dust of Braj. So, interestingly, it is said that dust of Braja is so valuable that even Krishna is controlled. And this is what Jayadev Goswami also writes. If you remember, Jagannath comes and writes. When Jayadev Goswami is writing Gita Govinda, and he's confused, how can I write this? And Krishna comes as Jaidev Goswami to write, Smaragarala Khandanam Mama Shirasi Mandanam Dehi Pada Pallavam Udaram Priye Charushile. Our Jaidev Goswami is writing that Krishna gets controlled by the service of Srimati Radharani. And at the same time, he desires to serve Srimati Radharani. So Srimati Radharani's position is higher than Sri Krishna's position. In this way, Gopal Bhatta Goswami's guru, Prabodhananda Saraswati, is also glorified Radharani. And of course, Gopal Bhatta Goswami, by the power of his bhajan, Radharaman appeared. Enough said. Radharani is appearing as Radharaman. So we finished Sanatana Goswami, Rupa Goswami, Jiva Goswami, Gopal Bhatta Goswami. Now please come to the works of Raghunath Das Goswami. Raghunath Das Goswami, 45 years he lived on the banks of Radha Kund. So he's like the most powerful authority on Radha Tattva. Now please repeat what Raghunath Das Goswami is writing. Tavai vasmi, tavai vasmi. Na jivami twayavina. Iti vidnyaya devi tvam. Nayamam charanantike. What is he saying? Tava eva asmi, tava eva asmi, na jivami tvaya vina. Hey Radharani, I belong to your lotus feet. I belong to your lotus feet. Without service to you, na jivami, I cannot live. Iti vidnyaya, understanding this. Iti vidnyaya devi tvam. Oh Radharani, understanding this. Nayamam charanantike. Please keep me close to your lotus feet. Ha ha. 45 years he was burning in separation like this. And therefore, very rightly so, when Raghunath Das Goswami was crying in Radha Kund like this, he was chanting Harinam. And when it was very hot, Radharani came with her sari cloth and she covered the head of Raghunath Das Goswami. Shripad Sanatan Goswami is doing Brajmandal, Giriraj Parikrama, and he comes to Radha Kund and he's saying, what is this? Raghunath baithke jap kar rahe hai? Or Vrishabhanu Nandini Praneshwari Hari Daseshwari Srimati Radharani is serving him. Sanatan Goswami went to Raghunath Das Goswami and said, you came to Radha Kund to serve Radharani or to take service from Radharani? No, no, to serve Radharani. He said, what are you saying? I saw Radharani protecting you. She was sweating. But she was protecting you just because you were chanting Krishna Nam. He said, ah, theek hai, theek hai. What am I supposed to do? You make a bhajan kutir for yourself. If you have a problem, you can just keep a ceiling for yourself. Why trouble Radharani from her eternal pastimes? So, theek hai. But Raghunath Das Goswami felt, abhi kutir utir banana, it'll be too much. Fundraising karna padega abhi iske liye. Kaise karu? To chhod do. He left. After a few months, again he's chanting Hare Krishna, and he's chanting the names of Radharani. Hare is Radharani. So at that time, one tiger is coming and sipping water from Radha Kund next to him, and he has no clue. He's closing his eyes and chanting japa. Krishna is performing his pastimes and thinking, someone is chanting the names of Radharani. That someone is Raghunath Das Goswami. And a tiger is sitting next to him. What if the tiger jumps? Before the tiger jumps, I will shoot him with an arrow. So that Krishna, who is Tribhanga Lalita Shama Sundar, dropped his flute. And like Ramachandra, he picked up the bow. Lokabhiramam ranarangadhiram Rajivanetram Raghuvamshanatham Karunyarupam Karunakarantam Shri Ramachandram Sharanam Prapadhye. Ranarangadhiram. Oh, he who holds the bow and arrow to fight. So that Krishna picked up the bow. Sanatan Goswami, again, somehow it coincided in his parikrama. Because see, if you do good parikrama, the phala at the end is darshan of Radha Krishna. That is what he was getting. But only thing, it was in the wrong place. So again he saw Krishna's, arrow to treta yug ka tha, braj mein Radha Kund mein arrow bo sab kyu chahiye, dekha to Raghunath Das Goswami chanting kar rahe hain. Unke paas gaye, bole, aapka problem kya hai? Aapko chanting karna hai, to aap chanting karo na, to fir aap, why you taking help service from Radharani and Krishna? Ek din Radharani sari pakade, dusre din Krishna abhi dhanush pakade, to aap chahte kya ho ab? He said, oh, I'm sorry, I didn't realize, I'm just chanting Harinam. Yes, you're chanting so ecstatically that they're coming to see you. You cover yourself in a bhajan kutir. So that Raghunath Das Goswami was weeping and crying in separation. He said, Tava eva asmi, tava eva asmi, tava eva asmi, na jiva ami tvaya vina. Hey Radharani, I belong to you, I belong to you, I belong to your service. Without that service, there is no use of my life. Iti vidnaya devi tvam. Hey Devi, understanding this, nayamam charanantike, keep me close to your lotus feet. This is one prayer we can offer. Radharani, please keep me in this world, in the mission of your service. Because Radharani is non-different from Shachinandan Gaurahari. Our approach towards Radharani is through Gauravatar. All the time. Please repeat. Aradito Navavanam.
Aradito Navavanam.
Vrajakananaste.
Vrajakananaste.
Naraditam Navavanam.
Naraditam Navavanam.
Vraja eva dure.
Aradito
Dvijasuto.
Vrajanagaraste
Naradito
Dvijasuto
Nataveha Krishna. Navadvip Shataka, Prabodhananda Saraswati. Prabodhananda Saraswati is saying, Araditam Navavanam Vrajanagaras Vrajakananaste. If someone worships the nine islands of Navadvip, oh, then they are successfully worshipping the 12 forests of Braj. Naraditam Navavanam. But if someone is not worshipping Navadvip, Vraja eva dure. Braj bahut dur hai. Aradito Dvijasuto. If someone worships Dvijasuta, Jagannath Mishra's son, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then Vraja Nagaraste, he is worshipping Krishna. Naradito Dvijasuto. If he is not worshipping Gauranga, Nataveha Krishna, then he is not worshipping Krishna. So our mood is no Gauranga, no Krishna. K-N-O-W. But no Gauranga, no Krishna. N-O. So if you K-N-O-W Gauranga, then you K-N-O-W Krishna. But if you N-O Gauranga, then you N-O Krishna. So no Gauranga, no Krishna. No Gauranga, no Krishna. For us, we worship Radharani, we worship Sri Krishna through Shachinandan Gaurahari. This is our Gaudiya Parampara. Because Gaudiya not just means worship of Param Gauri, it also means worship of Gaura, Gaudiya, Gauravatar. Yatha yatha Gaura Padara Vinde, Vindeta Bhaktim Krita Punyarashi, Prabodhananda Saraswati, Chaitanya Chandramrita. He says, to the extent the moon increases in size, what happens to the tides in the ocean? Yes, Prabhu? It rises, exactly. So similarly, I request all the devotees who are like tides here also to rise. So please don't sleep. As the moon of Gaur Katha is increasing in size, may the tide of our enthusiasm also increase. Prabodhananda Saraswati says, as the moon increases in size, from Amavasya to Purnima, the tides also increase. Similarly, just as our love for Gaura Chandra increases, the tides of Seva in the ocean of Radharani's Prem increases naturally. We don't have to make any extra endeavor to get Radha Prem. Just worship Shachinandan Gaurahari. Everything is there. Eka Chaitanya Chandra Paramakarunaya Sarvam Avishchakara. He says, Ekash Chaitanya Chandra, do pair pakadni ki avashakta nahi. Do logon ki, Radha or Krishna. Ekash Chaitanya Chandra. Just hold the feet of Gaurahari. Parama Karunaya Sarvam Avishchakara. He is very, very merciful. He gives you Radha and Krishna. Huh? Very wonderful. So Raghunath Das Goswami is saying to Radharani, yes, my dear Praneshwari, I want your seva. Now please repeat. Bhajami Radha,
Aravinda Netram,
Smarami Radha,
Madhura
Smitasyam, Vadami Radha,
Karuna
Bharadham,
Tato
Mamanyasti,
Gati
Nakapi.
Raghunath Das Goswami. He says, Bhajami Radham Aravinda Netram. Oh, what is the object of my worship? Radharani's eyes. Bhajami Radham Aravinda Netram. Smarami Radham Madhurasmitasyam. Oh, I just want to remember Srimati Radharani's smiling face. Vadami Radha Karunabharadram. And I speak to everyone about the mercy of Radharani. Tatho Mama Anya Gati Nakapi. Therefore, I have no other gati or destination except the feet of Radharani. They're all sold out. And this is Raghunath Das Goswami. Finally, let's come to Raghunath Bhatta Goswami. What was Raghunath Bhatta Goswami attached to? Bhagavatam. Yes. So please come. Raghunath Bhatta Goswami would read Srimad Bhagavatam in 6, 6, 7, 7, 8, 8 melodies. This Srimad Bhagavatam, we see all the contributors to the Srimad Bhagavatam are also fanatically attached to the lotus feet of Radharani. First and foremost, Narada Muni, who inspired the appearance of Bhagavat. That Narada Muni, to get Brajbas, to get the service of Radharani, is ready to become, ready to give up his sannyas. He forgets sannyas, he's ready to give up his male body. Narada became Naradi Gopi. He jumped into Kusuma Sarovara Manasa Ganga. Kalindi Nandini Vipulataranga Radha Kunda Tata Kunja Kutir. Bhaktivinoda Thakur. He jumped into Kusuma Sarovar. Who? Not Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Narada Muni. Narada Muni jumped into Kusuma Sarovar and came out as Naradi Gopi. And that Narada Muni is inspiring whom? Vyasadev. Now Vyasadev is also attached to the lotus feet of Radharani. Even in the Puranas, even in the Vedas. Please repeat. Yatra Radha Priya Vishnu.
Yatra Radha Priya Vishnu.
Tasya Kundam Priyam Tatha.
Tasya Kundam Priyam Tatha.
Sarva Gopeshu Saivaika.
Sarva
Vishnur Atyanta Vallabha.
This is Vyasadeva speaking in the Puranas. Yatra Radha Priya Vishnu. Just like Radharani is very dear to Vishnu. Huh? Is Radharani dear to Vishnu? Ye to rasabhas ho gaya. What is the Jodi? Divine couple? Vishnu, Lakshmi Devi and Vishnu. Similarly, Lord Shiva and mother? Ramachandra and mother? Radharani and Sri? This is proper Jodi. So we at ISKCON Whitefield know that. Vyasadev doesn't know that. He is saying, Yatra Radha Priya Vishnu. Galat ho gaya, nahi? Correct kar dein hum? Nahi. Correct it, kuch nahi karna hai. Sab kuch correct hai. Everything is perfect. Why? He is saying, oh, that Radharani who is so dear to Krishna, that Krishna is not a mere mortal. He is Vishnu. He is not a boy of this world to be attached to some girl. No. That Radharani is Ladini Shakti of Krishna. But who is that Krishna? Vishnu. So therefore, to instill this point, he says the word Vishnu 2 times in the same verse. Yatra Radha Priya Vishnu Tasya Kundam Priyam Tatha Sarva Gopeshu Saiveka Vishnur Atyanta Vallabha. Radharani is very dear to Krishna, who is none different from Vishnu. Similarly, Radha Kund is also very dear to Krishna. That's the purport of this verse. Chalo, continue. Vyasadev, what else does he say about Radharani? Devi Krishna Mai Prokta.
Radhika Para Devata.
Sarva. What is that? Sarva Lakshmi Mai Sarva.
Sarva Lakshmi Mai Sarva.
Kanta Sammohini Para.
Kanta Sammohini Para.
Who is Radharani? Says Vyasadev.
Devi. She is Devi. Krishna Mai.
Krishna Mai. Krishna Mai means? Yes?
Filled with Krishna.
Filled with Krishna, says. What's your name? Om. Of course. Pranava Sarva Vedeshu. Of all the Vedic mantras, I am Om. So if Om is speaking, it must be true.
Krishna Mai means filled with Krishna. Imagine a rasgulla. Tomorrow is Ekadashi. Today you can think. Imagine a rasgulla. You take the gula and you squeeze it. What comes out? Okay, now you squeeze it like this. What comes out? Oh. Then when you eat, what is there in the tongue? Then what's there in the fingers? You shake hands with someone, what's there in his hand? Ah. So in this way, that gula is rasamai. So much filled in rasa that wherever that gula goes, only fills with rasa. This is Krishnamai Radha. So much filled with Krishna. Krishna Seva. Krishna Mata, Krishna Pita, Krishna Dhana Pran. Bolo Krishna, Bhajo Krishna, Koro Krishna Siksha. Just like Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Gauranga Mahaprabhu we see. Running all over the place. Please repeat. Kaha Mora Prananath. Murali Vadan. Kaha Jao Kaha Pao. Brajendra Nandan. Kaviraj Goswami, Chaitanya Charitamrita. That Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is running in the Antya Leela. Kaha Mora Prananath Murali Vadan. Oh, where is the Lord of my life who plays the flute? Kaha Jaun Kaha Paun Brajendra Nandan. Oh, what should I do? Where should I go to find that Krishna? This is Devi, Krishna Mai Radha. Radhika Paradevata. Vyasadeva is saying this Radharani is not a girl. He's not a woman. Definitely not a superwoman. Who is this Radharani? Paradevata. Innumerable demigoddesses headed from Annapurna Devi to Parvati Devi. Ambanupura Chandra Mauli Rabala Aparnauma Parvati Kali Haimavati Triyatriyayani Katyayani Bhairavi Savitri Navayovana Shubakara Samrajya Lakshmi Prada. All of them. They are at the feet of Lakshmi. And Lakshmi, not one, innumerable such Lakshmis are at the feet of Srimati Radhika. This is that Radharani. She is not a concocted Gaudiya twist to the whole tale. Back in the Brahma Vaivarta Puran, please repeat. Radhyate yaya sa radha radhaiva radhyate maya. Vyasadeva is describing in the Brahma Vaivarta Puran, who is Radharani? Oh, Radhyate Yayasa Radha. She who constantly without a break serves Krishna. And second meaning, Radhaiva Aradhyate Maya. She whom constantly Krishna serves without a break. That is Radharani. Such beautiful description is given of Radha. Radharani. So this is Vyasadeva. So many places, Garga Samhita also, Brahma Vaivarta Puran also, up to Rig Veda also, Radha Tattva is described. So Narada is intoxicated, Vyasa is intoxicated. How about Vyasadeva's son, Shukadeva Goswami? He is not Shuka, he is Shri Shuka. He is Radharani's parrot. In fact, in the Brahma Vaivarta Puran it is described that Radharani, on her left hand, she has Shuka, parrot. And she says, she speaks the Bhagavatam and the parrot repeats. Line by line. And then when the parrot does a good job, she puts a pomegranate seed in the mouth. As Kripa. When all the pomegranate is over, that parrot flies into this world to give that to us. Sri Shuka. So in this way, Shukadeva Goswami is also Radhamaya. Sarvam Radhamayam Jagat. Also, Shukadeva Goswami is so tempted to speak about Radharani in the Bhagavatam. Why not speak and tell the whole world the glory of my Praneshwari? But then, as he starts speaking, the gopis appear in his consciousness and say, we are very shy. Please don't describe us so publicly. Because the nature of bhakti is humility, dainya bhav. You don't want your glories to be spread everywhere. So the gopis said, please don't. Usko chipa chipa kar rakhein, yehi theek hai. Indirectly, bolne, Shukadeva Goswami said, but if you say like this, I want to glorify. duty of a devotee is to glorify. I want to. They said, theek hai, tu ghuma kar fir. Paroksha vadam mama priyam. Indirectly, kuch. Theek. Tu sirf Radha naam le lo. Baki sab gopis, I'll keep to the side. I'll just describe Radha Rani. The gopi said, no, actually the sages, if you see, not all of them are bhaktas. Devanam, demigods are also sitting. Atha bhakta, devotees are also sitting. Atha mukta, liberated ones are also sitting. Suhridam, some who are in friendship with Krishna. Mixed crowd hai. Prabhuji, mixed crowd hai aaj. Kuch simple rakhte hai. Sirf devotees hote to hum log deep jate. Sometimes, you know, like we organize programs, so we all discuss. We had one devotee coming in America. So he was saying, Prabhuji, main kya bolu? So I was saying, Prabhuji, it's a mixed crowd. It ranges between someone who's chanting 16 rounds and is a Brahminic initiated devotee to someone who's coming for the first time. So now you see, yathechasi tatha kuru. So Shukadev Goswami, when he had to do program also, mixed crowd. So he didn't. Also at the same time, if he would have said Radha, so much Amrit is there in these two syllables, we may not taste it. But Sri Shukha, Radharani's parrot will taste it. Shukha Mukhad Amrita Drava Samyutam. That Amrita Drava will come from the lips of Shukha. So if he says Radha, what will happen? Finished. So before Parikshit Maharaj finishes, Shukadev Goswami's narration will finish because he will be in ecstasy. Takshak is not going to wait. Nahi, aap karo, aapka chalu rakho. Ek bar Shukadev Goswami jag jaye, fir aapki katha hokar, fir main dhasunga. Wo to nahi karenge. 7 days means 7 days. Now, whoever goes in ecstasy, that is their problem. So he said, okay, I shouldn't say Radha. Because if I say Radha, I will not be able to finish Bhagavatam in 7 days. Because these two syllables are intoxicating, not just for Shukadev Goswami, but even for Sri Krishna. When Krishna was given his Upanayan by Sandipani Muni, he was given different mantras. But before that, in Braj, he was accepted by a guru called Bhagori Rishi. And Bhagori Rishi gave Krishna a very wonderful mantra. He gave him a Narayana mantra. Chanting the names of Narayana. And told Krishna, you should chant the names of Narayana. You will be protected. Krishna said, okay. Mother Yashoda told Krishna, hey, go to that temple, sit there, run your fingers under a cloth and chant the names of Narayana. Krishna said, okay, like a good boy, he took bath, he combed his hair and he went to the temple. And he sat there, Narayana, Narayana, Narayana. ले बोर हो रहा है मुझे मैं अपना ही नाम ले रहा हूं कृष्णा चेंटिंग हिज ओन नेम्स ले आनंद नहीं है एट दैट टाइम वृंदा देवी सेंट हर पैरट द पैरट वेंट एंड सॉ बिकॉज वृंदा देवी वांटेड टू नो इफ कृष्णा चेंटिंग प्रॉपरली तो सीसीटीवी कैमरा का उद्गम स्थान वहां से है वॉट एवर साइंटिफिक डिस्कवरीज वी हैव इट ऑल ओरिजिनेट्स इन ब्रजमंडल So the CCTV cameras are the parrots of Braj. Kya chal raha hai? So therefore it is worthy of a parrot to speak the pastimes through Bhagavatam. So one parrot went and sat there. The parrot said, what do you want? He said, no ecstasy. I wish I had a dhara. A stream of happiness. Parrot said, Tara, 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 Tara. But after all, it's a bird. So in America, someone with little intelligence, we say, oh, he has bird brain. Bird brain. So birds don't have a lot of brain. So, but this parrot was super intelligent. He put a fake yoga maya covering of forgetfulness. So he was saying, Tara, 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 Tara. Then he forgot what he was saying. So he flipped the syllables because he didn't know what he was saying. Then he started saying, Radha, 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 Radha. And now Krishna is chanting Narayan mantra.
the ecstasy is coming from here. He said, Aniyo, keep going, keep giving more. And now that mantra Krishna chanting, Radha, 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 Radha. Tears are coming down his eyes. Mother Yashoda is seeing from the kitchen. My Lala is chanting his Narayan mantra so well. Unko kya pata wo Lala kya chanting kar rahe. Therefore, Prabodhana Saraswati says, Devanamata Bhakta Mukta Suhridam Matyanta Duram Chayat Premanandarasam Mahasukakaram Chocharitam Prematah Jalpatyashru Mukho Haristadamritam Radheti Me Jeevanam. Oh, that Hari who makes others cry by taking things away from them is now crying sitting in Vrindavan when he is experiencing divine love by chanting these two syllables, Radha. Bolo Radha Shama Sundar ki. Oh, this is Shukadev Goswami. And therefore, intoxicated and fearing not to say these two syllables, he says it in an indirect way. Please chant. Anaya Radhito Nunam. Bhagavan Haririshwaram. Yanno Vihaya Govinda. Preetoyam Manayadraha. Canto 10, Chapter 30, Text 28, Bhagavatam. Only place where the name Radha has been directly given. There are other places also, but not as Radha. Other names of Radharani are given. So here 10:30:28 says, Anaya a Radhito Nunam. When Krishna disappears from the Rasalila and the gopis are searching for Krishna, they see Krishna's lotus footprints with the footprints of Srimati Radharani. And the gopis at that time say, oh, this gopi is way more qualified than all of us. She has served and pleased Krishna so much that Krishna has left all of us to take the service of this gopi. Anaya aradhito nunam, indeed. And who is this Krishna? Bhagavan Hari Ishwaraha. So that there is no confusion. No confusion. Acha, who? Now this is Srimad Bhagavatam. Among those who know Srimad Bhagavatam, up on the list is Lord Shiva. Aham Vedmi, Shukho Vetti, Vyasa Vetti Na Vetti Va. Lord Shiva is saying, who knows Srimad Bhagavatam when he was asked? He says, Aham Vedmi, I know. Shukho Vetti, Shukho also knows. Vyasa Vetti Na Vetti Va. Vyas may or may not know. Are Shivji, you to author hai. No, what Srila Shiva is saying is correct. Why? Because Bhagavatam is Bhaktya Bhagavatam Grahiyam. Bhagavatam must be accepted by devotion. Na buddhya, not by buddhi. Na cha tikaya, not just by commentaries. You can rattle the commentaries for a long time, but if there is no devotion, no import of the Bhagavatam. So if Vyasa is taken as Krishna avatar, then how can he have bhakti for himself? So he doesn't have bhakti. If he is Krishna, Krishna has devotion for his devotees. But the definition of bhakti is Krishna Anushilanam. How can Krishna have Anushilanam for himself? So if Vyasa is taken to be Krishna, then Navetti. If Vyasa is taken to be a disciple of Narada, Vetti. Does Krishna know Bhagavatam? No. Aham Veda aham samatitani vartam. Theek hai. But Bhagavatam nahi. Ved, Puran, Upanishad, yes. All the Tattva Siddhanta Krishna knows. But the movements of the heart? Krishna knows Bhagavatam? Vetti na vetti va. If you see Krishna as Bhagavan, then he doesn't know. But when Krishna appears as Shachinandan Gaura Hari, then he knows. Therefore it is said, please repeat. Jao Bhagavata Pado. Vaishnavera Sthane. Ekanta Ashraya Koro. Chaitanya Charane. यदि भागवत पढ़ना हो तो शुद्ध भक्त के सानिध्य में ही पढ़ सकते हैं. By our reading, we will not learn. But in the association of someone who's a devotee, then we can learn by taking shelter of Gauranga. Lord Shiva then goes on to glorify Srimati Radharani. Please sing. Please repeat. Makeshwari.
Makeshwari.
Kriyeshwari.
Kriyeshwari.
Swadeshwari.
Swadeshwari.
Sureshwari.
Sureshwari.
Triveda Bharatishwari. Pramana Shashaneshwari. Rameshwari. Kshameshwari. Pramodakananeshwari. Vrajeshwari. Vrajadipe. Shri Radhike. Namostute. Makeshwari, Kriyeshwari, Swadeshwari, Sureshwari, Triveda Bharatishwari, Pramana Shashaneshwari, Rameshwari, Shameshwari, Pramodakananeshwari, Vrajeshwari, Vrajadipe, Sri Radhike Namostate. So, Lord Shiva is also glorifying Radharani as Makeshwari, Kriyeshwari, all these names. Hey Radharani, you are my supreme goddess. So this is how exalted Radha Tattva is. Glorified by devotees across the continent of Brahmanda, all over the place. Not just in our sampradaya, people outside the sampradaya are also glorifying. Like Sripad Nimbarka Acharya, glorifying Radharani. Huh? Sripad Vallabhacharya's son, Sripad Vitthala Acharya, he is saying, please repeat, Shama Sundara. Shikhanda Shekhar, Smerahas, Murali Manohara, Radhika Rasikamam, Kripanidhe, Swapriya, Charana Kinkarim Kuru. Vitthalnath, the son of Sripad Vallabhacharya, is praying. Huh? Shama Sundara, oh Shama Sundara, Shikhanda Shekhara, he who has a peacock feather. Smerahasa, he who has a soft smile. Murali Manohara, he who captivates our mind by playing the murali. Radhika Rasika, oh Radha Ramana, I have only one desire. Swapriya Charana Kinkarim Kuru, make me a maid servant at the lotus feet of your Priya, that is Srimati Radharani. Bas, nothing else. Nothing else. Then he continues, Prananatha Vrishabhanu Nandini, Shri Mukhabjarasa Lola Satpada, Radhika Padatale Kritastitim, Tvambhajami Rasikendra Shekhara. Krishna is asking Vitthalnath, why are you worshipping me? Because Vitthalnath was worshipping Krishna for many, many years. On top of Govardhan, he had a nice Giridhari Gopal deity. And then to that deity, he would say, I'm worshipping you. Tvambhajami Rasikendra Shekhara. Hey Krishna, I am worshipping you. Krishna said, Are kya chahiye bolo? Ichha bolo. You tell me what you want. Vitthalnath said, Radhika pada tale krita sthitim. Radhika pada tale krita sthitim. Make situation in life in such a way that I somehow mysteriously land under the lotus feet of Radharani. Radhika pada tale krita sthitim. Aisi sthiti bana do jeevan mein. That I am under the lotus shelter and the mercy of Srimati Radharani. Bas, aur kuch nahi chahiye mujhe. Nothing else. This is so exalted. Today we were discussing, you know, wide range of different personalities. Shat Goswamis, Bhakti Siddhanta, Saraswati Thakur, Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Jaidev Goswami, now Vitthalnath. Everyone. But I want to tell you finally as we wrap up. These personalities are worshipping Radharani, yes. But this tattva is so exalted
that even Brajendra Nandana Shama Sundara Rasika Shekhara Radha Ramana Badha Harana Shri Krishna also gets attracted. Huh? He also gets attracted. Please chant. Radha Purna Shakti Krishna Purna Shakti Man. Dui Vastu Bheda Nahi Shastrera Praman. Radharani is Krishna, Krishna is Radharani. No difference. Radharani was asked, who is Krishna? Radharani is asked, who is Krishna? Look at Radharani's answer. Mama eva paurusham rupam. Gopika janamohanam. Radharani is saying, this Gopinath that you see, mama eva paurusham rupam, he is my male form. Mera purush avatar hai. Haribo. Mama eva paurusham rupam. If I am para prakriti, this is param purusha. Mama eva paurusham rupam gopika janamohanam. This Gopinath is me in a male form. Bas, no difference. But Radharani is 10 million times more beautiful than Krishna. 10? Ah. How beautiful is Krishna? Ten million times lesser than Srimati Radharani. He is Pakka Gaudiya. He is describing Krishna's beauty through Radharani's beauty. Yeah, Krishna's beauty is described all over the place. Rupa Madhuri. But that Rupa Madhuri it is described becomes eclipsed in front of Radharani's beauty. And therefore, Kaviraj Goswami is describing. That Radharani has 10 million times more beauty, 10 million times more ability, 10 million times more service than Krishna. Although she originates from Krishna. And this bewilders Krishna's mind. Arey, aise kaise ho sakta hai? That which originates from me, how can it be more qualified than me? But that logic fails because as soon as Krishna looks at Radharani, what happens? Arey, puchhe ki kya nahi hota hai? Vamshi Vibhushita Karan, that Krishna who plays the flute, he looks at Radharani. Venum Karani Patitam. The flute falls from his hand. Last night we were discussing why Radharaman doesn't have a flute. Because Radharaman is standing but he doesn't have a flute. You know why? He was actually having a flute. But accidentally, he was attacked by an arrow of sidelong glance of Srimati Radharani. Huh? What happened then? Radharaman, who's playing the flute? The flute fell from his hand and he didn't realize and he went on blowing air. That's why we never hear Krishna play the flute from the altar. Do you ever hear Krishna play the flute from the altar? No. Why? Because the flute has fallen from his hand. He's blowing in air. You know, just like sometimes when someone who's not experienced blows the conch shell. Baj nahi raha hai kuch. Ah, bas. Effort is being put. Unlimited input, no output. So the flute is falling. Venum karani patitam skalitam shikhandam. The peacock feather is falling. Vrastancha pita vasanam. Krishna's Anga Vastra is falling. Vrajaraja Suno, that Krishna who's self-controlled. Nityo Nityanam, Chetanas Chetananam, Eko Bahunam, Yo Vidadati Kaman, Ano Aniyan, Mato Mayan, Teek hai sab Braj ke bahar. Braj mein nahi chalega. Na. Braj ke bahar honge Dwarkadish. Par Braj mein? Radhika Padatale Kritastitim Tvam Bhajami Rasikendra Shekhar. So Vrindavan doesn't have kingdom because king hai nahi. Vrindavan is queendom because there's only queen, Srimati Radhika. Bas, only Radharani. No one else. Everyone is at the feet of Radharani, including Shama Sundar. So, Venum Karani Paditam, the flute is falling, the peacock feather is falling, the yellow Pita Vastra is falling, Vraja Raja Suno, and then Yasya Kataksha. With one Kataksha of Srimati Radharani, Yasya Kataksha Saraghata Vimurchitasya. Ho gai, finished. Kon?
Janmadhyasya Yatonvaya Aditarata Chartheshva Bhidyaswara Tene Brahma Rudaya Adikavaye. Yam Brahma Varunendra Rudra Maruta Stunvanti Divya Istavir Keshava Drita Sukara Rupa Bas Murchitasya.
One Brajrasik Sadhu writes, Radharani is so beautiful that Krishna faints in ecstasy. Not just Krishna, his partial expansion as Vishnu never wakes up. Abhi bhi soye hain Vaikunth mein. He has not woken up because once his source Krishna saw Srimati Radharani, then all the incarnations went off to sleep. This is Radharani. Radharani. So Krishna is completely conquered. And then as Gaura Avatar evolves, Krishna desires, I wish I can experience this mood. Radha Krishna Pranaya Vikritir Ladhinir Shaktirasman Ekat Manam Api Bhuvi Pura Deha Bhedam Gatauta. One became two. But in Kali, Chaitanyakyam Prakatam Aduna Tadvayam Cha Aikyam Aptam Radha Bhava Dhyuti Suvalitam Naomi Krishna Swarupam. Shachinandan Gaurahari is coming. Nidhuvana Nagari Mohita Manasa Vigadita Gadgada Bhasham Sakhe Kalaya Gauramudaram. When Gauranga Mahaprabhu is appearing, what is happening? It is Krishna, but he's speaking disjoint words. He's looking at Jagannath and he's not even able to say Jagannath. Kaviraj Goswami describes this in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Mahaprabhu so much in ecstasy looking at Jagannath, he's not able to say Jagannath, he's saying so much ecstasy. Where is that coming from? Not from Krishna. It is the heart of Radharani. Vigadita gadgada bhasham. So therefore, the way to serve Srimati Radharani is to take shelter of the lotus feet of Shachinandan Gaurahari. We all must be fanatically attached to Gauranga. Nothing else. Kuch bhi nahi chahiye. Matsya Kurma Varaha Narsimha Vamana Parashurama Rama Balarama Buddha Kalki Sabko Pranam. But my heart is at the feet of Gauranga. Gauravatar. By taking shelter of Gauranga, taking the names of Gauranga, studying the Chaitanya Charitamrita of Gauranga, praying to Gauranga, remembering Gauranga, worshipping Gauranga as deities, sharing this mercy of Gauranga by preaching and spreading Krishna consciousness, chanting Harinam Sankirtan, chanting Japa, engaging in the limbs of Bhakti. When Gauranga is happy, the blessings come from the heart. And who is the heart? Radharani. So the way to get Krishna is through the door of Radharani. The way to get Radharani is through the door of Chaitanya. And the way to get to Gauranga is through Nithai. Jodi tumi rakte chaho Gaurangero sone, choto Hari Daser katha thake jeno mone. If someone wants to be close to Gauranga, jodi tumi rakte chaho Gaurangero sone. If you desire to be at the lotus feet of Gauranga, choto Hari Daser katha thake jeno mone. So rules are there for Gaur Ashray Sharanagati, but Nityananda is free flowing. Nitaira charana satya tahara sevaka nitya nitai pada sada korvas narotama bolo dukhi nitai more karo sukhi rakho ranga charanero pas. So therefore, on Radhashtami and service of Radhashtami, two things are established through this discussion. One, the exalted nature of Radha Tattva. How everyone is at the feet of Radharani, including Shama Sundar. How there is so much Shastric Praman for what we are following. And second, how impossible it is for us to get there. Please understand, there must be a tension. What tension? One end of the string says, it is so lofty, but I want it. And the second end says, it is so lofty, but I don't deserve it. So the lower end of the string says, I don't deserve it. The higher end of the string says, I want it. The tension must be built between, I want it, to I don't deserve it. I want it. I don't deserve it. The more the tension and the string, the more is mercy. If you just say, I don't deserve, I don't deserve, I don't deserve, but where do you desire? Do you desire to get the lotus feet of Radha and Krishna? But if you just frivolously say, I want it, but you don't feel dainya bhav that I don't deserve it, tension is not created. So what is important for Radha Kripa is tension. Please explain, what is the lower end? I don't deserve it. This is so exalted, I don't deserve it. What is the higher? I want it. I wish I get it. Hari Hari Kabe Mor Hoibe Sudina Bhajiva Shri Radha Krishna Hoya Prema Dhina Hari Hari Kabe Mor Hoibe Sudina. Narottam Das Thakur. Hari Hari Kabe Mor Hoibe Sudina. Lower end of the string. When will that day be mine? I don't deserve it. Then Bhajiva Shri Radha Krishna Hoya Prema Dhina. Oh, I want to worship Radha Krishna being completely dipped in Krishna Prem. Higher end of the string. So this tension must be created in a sadhaka. I absolutely don't deserve it, but I absolutely want it. By that, inner desire and external service to the mission of Gauranga and Nityananda. Then, when they are pleased, they give Radha Krishna prem. Then everything will come. Srila Prabhupada took this flag of Radha Krishna Bhakti and flooded the world with Krishna prem. Please tell me, before 1966, how many went to Vrindavan? Deserted place. Very few went. But now, Kartik mein pair rakhne ko jagah nahi hai. The shopkeepers in Braj say, aapke Prabhupada ji Maharaj ke karan aaj Braj dekho, khil utha. Pehle to koi Braj jadan aate nahi the, sadhu sant aate the. Aajkal grihasth bhi aate hain, bachche bhi aate hain, brahmachari bhi aate hain, sanyasi bhi aate hain, ek-ek mahina parikrama laga kar chale jate hain. Prabhupada opened up Vrindavan to the world. And for that, he left Vrindavan 2 times. He left that Vrindavan to come here and settled in this Vrindavan. Then left this Vrindavan to give Vrindavan to the world. After giving Vrindavan to the world, came back to this Vrindavan, left his body to go back to that Vrindavan. So Prabhupada opened the gates of Braj. How many people go to Radhakund today? Innumerable. So Prabhupada is showering Radharani's grace. Because without Radharani's grace, who can come to Radhakund? No one. So all that you have to do, very simple. If we want Radha Krishna Prem, if we want Gaur Nitai Prem, we have to hold to the feet of Prabhupada. Jadi Prabhupada na hoi to, tave ki hoi to, ei jivana vahita kishe. As Srila Jayapataka Maharaj writes. What would we be doing if not for Srila Prabhupada? Prabhupada has spread the glories of Tulsi. Kitne sthano mein aajkal subah aur sham Tulsi ki seva hoti hai. Even Indians wouldn't be doing Tulsi so much. But now you see, in Karachi, Pakistan, 5 o'clock in the morning, you see, Ei Nivedana Dharo Sakhi. Karachi, Pakistan mein hoke Nivedan karne Tulsi se, Seva adhikar diye koro nijadasi. That too in Bengali. Prabhupada spread Bhagavatam. Every morning, everywhere around the world, people are hearing Bhagavatam, reciting, call and response, the verses of Bhagavatam. Chanting Krishna Naam on the streets, japa, worshipping deities. This is the mercy of Srila Prabhupada. So therefore, on the occasion of Radhashtami, we want to pray to Srimati Radharani. Hey Srimati Radharani, I don't deserve to get your kainkaryam.
But at the same time, I desire to assist my Guru Parampara even in the spiritual world. In this world and in the spiritual world. And we pray to Srila Prabhupada, Prabhupada, please always keep me at your lotus feet. All those devotees who are actively engaged in this congregation to cultivate devotees, to get in newer devotees, to teach Shastra, to give them the opportunity to chant the holy name of Krishna. giving them the opportunity to chant the holy name of Krishna. Performing so many services to Vaishnavas. It is certainly a great, great expression of compassion. Because Radharani's mercy means we want to serve Krishna, but we want to have others also serve Krishna. Radharani serves Krishna, but she also takes pleasure when Lalita and Vishakha serve Krishna. So this is Radharani's mood. And that mood in this world is the missionary preaching activity. So all those devotees who are engaged in getting newer jivas in, sustaining and nourishing those who are already in, to go deeper in their sadhana, to go deeper in their seva, to go deeper in their swadhyaya, to have association of devotees, this is certainly very, very auspicious.